The streets of Gibraltar follow a very ancient pattern. It was created by the Moors when they built Medina al-Fat, the city of victory, the original city of Gibraltar. The Moorish layout of the streets was then retained by the Spaniards for the 266 years that Gibraltar was Spanish, and then by the British in the 308 years since the Treaty of Utrecht ceded Gibraltar to Britain. At the heart of the old city is the principal street of Gibraltar, which has been known by different names over the years. These names give an indication of how the street was perceived and how the attitude towards the street changed over time. Curiously, our principal street is the only one that has retained for many people a Spanish name as well as the English name. For many, this is still La Calle Real. But how did it acquire this name? It clearly harks right back to when Gibraltar was Spanish between 1462 and 1704. And there's an important clue to be found in the Cathedral of St. Mary the Crown. This is the coat of arms of Spain, the royal coat of arms, and today they are embedded here in the patio of the Church of St. Mary the Crown. But originally, they were not intended to be hidden away from the public gaze as they are today. The coat of arms reflects the status of Gibraltar after it was handed over by its owner, the Duke of Medina Sidonia, to the Spanish crown. Isabel la Católica, Isabel of Castile, demanded it from Medina Sidonia, and she got it in 1502. As the crown of Spain had obtained possession of Gibraltar, the Spanish royal coat of arms, in due course, were placed on the exterior of the belfry of the principal church. This happened around 1550, when the church was considerably expanded with the addition of the high altar and the two main side altars, at a time when the Emperor Charles V, the Holy Roman Emperor Charles V, was on the throne, and he was ruling in Spain as Charles I. The Spanish coat of arms on the church was a potent reminder that Gibraltar formed part of the dominions of the newly created Kingdom of Spain, which had come about because the parents of the Holy Roman Emperor Charles V had united the crowns of Aragon and Castile. Besides the Cathedral of St. Mary the Crown, the only other place in Gibraltar where we can see the arms of the Holy Roman Emperor Charles V is here at Southport Gates. The bell tower originally stood right in the middle of the street, right here, and it was under the bell tower that one accessed the patio of the Cathedral of St. Mary the Crown. What this means is that anybody coming into Gibraltar through the port or through the land entry into the city and walking up the main street towards the main square, today John Mackintosh Square, would at this point see ahead of them the belfry of the main church and above the door to the belfry, the Spanish royal coat of arms. And it is the presence of the Royal Spanish coat of arms on the street that gave the name Calle Real Royal Street, the name of this street. When Britain acquired Gibraltar in 1713 under the Treaty of Utrecht, new English names were given to the streets. But these names were the names that were used only by the Protestant elite, the merchants, and by the military authorities. The ordinary civilian residents continued to use the Spanish names for the streets, the names they'd always used. So Irish Town continued to be La Calle de Santa Ana. Governor's Garden Street, the name was later shortened to just simply Governor's Street, continued to be known as Calle Cordoneros, and so on. The original name given by the British to the northern section of Main Street would appear to have been the Great Street, and that is the name that appears on a 1712 list of rents that had to be paid to the governor. The list of rents of 1712 included 28 Jews who had shops here on the Great Street, as well as some Genoese and a few Spaniards who had stayed on after Gibraltar was taken in 1704. The Genoese included a butcher, a baker, a confectioner, an armourer, and three market gardeners. What is clear is that this has always been the principal street. The name Calle Real and the Great Street were not used to describe the entirety of what we today call Main Street. It can therefore be readily understood that in the years before the Great Siege, this principal section of the Main Street of Gibraltar should have been known as Waterport Street, because it was the street, that section of the Main Street, that led out to the commercial anchorage. The word port is an echo of the French word porte, meaning door or gate. So the term waterport, what it really means is the water gate. What we today call casemates gates are not the original gates that stood here at the northwest corner of Casemates Square. Indeed, in the years up to the Great Siege, there was only a single gate, this one here. And the reason for that is that it allowed better control of the people coming in and out of Gibraltar, and it was necessary for the security of the fortress. On the outside of the original gate was the entrance to the landing stage, to the commercial port. And originally, there was nothing in the shape of walls outside Casemates Gates, the water gate. The walls I'm standing on now came later. They were built some years after the Great Siege. So the city ended where the water gate was previously, just there. Today, we can see that above Casemates Gates, it is written that they are built on the site of the original gate, the Water Gate. So, there are two obvious features that defined the principal street. At the one end was the entrance to Gibraltar through the land port or the water port via Casemates Square, and at the other end, the church that jutted right out into the middle of the street. by the mid-19th century, the extent of Waterport Street was defined as ending here at what is today John Mackintosh Square. At the time, it was known as Commercial Square. The rest of what is today Main Street was then known by different names. This central section of the street was known as Church Street. The shorter, southernmost section of the street was known as Southport Street. The name Main Street was only adopted on the 5th of August 1913, and that is just over 100 years ago. Let us look now at the northern section of Main Street, what was previously called Waterport Street, and in particular at one aspect of the street. Waterport Street was at the centre of Gibraltar's commerce, together with Irish Town, in the Victorian period. And Irish Town was distinguished by the large merchant houses which had winches on the first floor that led into the storerooms, which were on the first floor. Waterport Street, on the other hand, was full of shops on the ground floor or street level. The shops in the 18th century Great Street, and right into the 19th century, were nothing like the shops that we see today. A visitor to Gibraltar in the early 19th century, a military man, described the shops and said they were mean looking, but that nevertheless, an enormous amount of trade was carried out in Gibraltar. Part of the reason for the shops being small and therefore being considered mean looking by outsiders is because of the typical design of the Gibraltar townhouse in the 19th century. In order to allow light and air to those rooms that did not face the street, houses were built round patios. Sometimes these patios were small, sometimes they were larger. The patio would be at the back of the shop, and opening up from the patio, there would sometimes be a store which was away from the street. And this was the pattern that continued throughout the Victorian era, the 19th century, with very few exceptions. One exception was the first department store in Gibraltar, the Cassez shop, which dated back to the 1890s and which was located just here. The Cassez shop sold ready-made clothing, boots and shoes, linen, glass, home household goods, a whole range of things. And they even had a special department for mourning, for people who were in mourning and wanted everything in black. And they even had envelopes and writing paper with a black border. The name of the shop is still recalled among the older generation, and they still refer to this as the Cassez Arcade. The upper stories of the patio continued to enjoy light and air, But insofar as the shops were concerned, the patios were completely roofed over and were lost. The size of the shops was one issue, their facades was another. And the shops that fronted onto Waterport Street in the 19th century, in the Victorian period, consisted primarily of a series of arches, window and door arches. Today, in order to appreciate this rhythm of window arches and door arches, you need to go to places like Irish Town or here in Governor's Street. Shops wanted to have larger shop windows, and in the years after World War II, most of the shops along Waterport Street were greatly improved and modernized, and large girders were placed above the windows and doors in order to allow for large plate glass window displays. The shops could now display a larger variety of goods for sale, but the character of Main Street at shop level had been changed forever. Now, in order to appreciate the Victorian character of the houses, we need to look up above ground floor level. It is then that we can begin to appreciate some of the architectural features of these buildings. Some properties were tiled, reflecting the influence of Portuguese masons and builders who came and settled in Gibraltar from the very early days of British Gibraltar. And some of these facades are in two colours of tile, and they make for a particularly attractive pattern. Some properties had iron balconies in the Regency style. Some of these balconies were completely enclosed. This particular balcony has an interesting history. If we look at old photographs, we will see that it was originally on the first floor. Later, it was moved from the first floor to the second floor because it inhibited the development and enlargement of the shops at street level. At least the balcony was moved. It was not removed. Other balconies were open to the elements. And what these balconies on Main Street achieved is that they gave those houses an air of grace and elegance. Some houses wanted to make an architectural statement, like this one at number 165. And you have the design of the balconies, which matches the frieze that runs up the center of the building. Indeed, the balconies on this property are particularly attractive. The facade of this building is particularly attractive, and if you look closely, you can see at the corner that it has the initials FB and the date 1904, which is the date when Federico Bado rebuilt the property. And what was originally the door here at the corner was later converted into a shop window. When Federico Bado wanted to build the house, he asked for planning permission to erect a three-story house with a wash house on top. And in fact, he was only allowed to build a two-story house with a wash house on top. What these houses all have in common is that they're fine examples of architectural style. And I'd like to emphasize the word style, because it is something that we have lost, not only on the former Waterport Street, but also in Gibraltar as a whole. Developers have been allowed to put up houses that lack character. Successive governments and planners should be chastised for this. They have shown a lack of vision. Developers should be obliged to include interesting architectural features in their designs instead of opting for what appear to be the cheapest options in order to maximize their profits. Next time, I shall be looking at one particular type of city centre property, the old hotels that once graced our main street and what was traditionally our main square.